it's Vicky. Welcome back to my channel. This is my day one to day seven Obsidian journey where I'm building my second brain. And if you're like me, consuming content all day but can't keep track of what you've learned, Obsidian might be the right platform for you. So let's check it out. Day one, starting from scratch. I was watching Jeff Koons' masterclass on art and creativity that day and decided to just start taking notes on Obsidian. At first, the experience wasn't too different from just, you know, noting down things on Word, but because I'm using the Zettelkasten method, I was very conscious to create one note for each concept instead of having everything on one page. This way, you can really break down the concepts into small building blocks and you can see the links between each. So if you ever find that you can't really put the things you learn into practice, this is a great exercise. So day one, that was all I was doing, getting used to typing notes in Obsidian. Day two, building connections. I wanted to try scripting my YouTube video on Obsidian today because these are the basis for my other writings on Twitter and my newsletter. And right now, my YouTube outline are just in one giant Word document. It's full of concepts, quotes, examples, anecdotes, but they're all buried in the endless text. But in Obsidian, I can separate them. I can create a note for each of these examples so I don't have to rewrite the example every time I use something. I can also build on existing ideas. So eventually I'll have my own library of great anecdotes, great quotes, great points that can build onto each other instead of Googling to find one every time I sit down to write. Here I made a link to an example I wanted to use from the documentary 14 Peaks. So once I created that, I'll go into the 14 Peaks note, write down the example. So every other time when I want to refer to this, I don't need to repeat the example again. I can just link to this note and it will already be written up. Day three, taking notes on the go. This is where I picked up the speed. I wanted to take more notes quickly on my phone and add some images of the books I was reading. So I took a bunch of notes on my mobile and then realized the notes don't automatically sync across devices. You either have to pay to sync them or for free, you have to put the notes in the cloud. So I chose to put my iPhone notes in my iCloud folder and here is how you would sync the notes. Okay, I'm back on my Mac, so I'm signed in. The Apple ID is the same as the one on my phone, so it should work. I just need to come to open another vault and open folder as vault. And there it is in my iCloud folder. If I could come here, there is Obsidian. I don't have anything else in this Apple ID, so I think if I click open, it should sync everything. Sweet! This is awesome. Okay, so yeah, that's how easy it is to sync between Apple devices. I know you can do the same with Dropbox and Google Drive as well. So I think if you use Android, it should be the same type of process. Otherwise, they also have a syncing option. Let me show you. So if we check out pricing, yeah. There are add-on services, so the syncing one is $8 a month, billed annually though. So that is an option. I think why people don't end up using the free options to sync is because of the encryption. So if that's something important to you, you can always $8 a month. I don't know if it's too much or not enough. Not sure, but yeah, anyway, that's possible. Otherwise, you know, you can use existing ways of doing this. Day four, midpoint check-in and customizing with themes. Now's probably a good time to do a midpoint check-in, midpoint-ish, on the graph. Here we go. Whoa. Okay. Well, let's see what I can do here. Oh, time lapse. Something satisfying to think that these thoughts and ideas are now in my head. There are quite a few different customization options you can do with your graph. I played around with some of them, but I think at this early stage, there are not enough notes to really see a big difference. I definitely need to do more linking between the different ideas, but if you know Zettelkasten, then you know more of the connections come when you do the permanent notes, when you review your literature notes together with fleeting notes. If you haven't seen that, check out the video up here where I talk about the Zettelkasten method. It is life-changing. But anyway, also I think I'm ready to check out themes and pick one. Let me do that today. Okay, let's go to it right now.
A few moments later.
Okay, let me use things. How does this one look? Let's see. Okay. I think this one looks better. I like that the links are blue. Those are very intuitive to let me know that those are links. Let's see the graph view. Okay. Will I be able to change the colors? Anyway, I'll figure that out. But okay, I think that looks good. I'll keep it like that for now. And then I might change it up. I don't know. I think this themes thing. Themes and also plugins will take me some time. So once a bit of time, I think today we'll call it a day here.
Day 5, going from input to output. Now here's where I started taking my notes and made them into output. Let me show you what I did with this article here.
Okay, so this is a perfect use case, an example of how you can leverage Obsidian so that when you're consuming content, it actually turns into something useful later down the road. So I saw this Wall Street Journal article on CEO compensation in 2020, and the finding was that Palantir CEO and DoorDash CEOs were the top compensated CEOs, but they both run very unprofitable businesses in 2020. So Palantir paid their CEO, Alex Karp, $1.1 billion in cash and in stocks and other forms of compensation. And DoorDash paid just over, I think, $400 million, while steady corporations that are proven to, you know, drive revenue, drive profits, like McDonald's and Starbucks, their CEO only received around 10 million, a little bit more than that, in the teens. And I think this brings in such interesting insights as to what do the market value, what do companies value in terms of CEO skills, how do we see potential? There are so many things I think we can unpack here. So I want to do either a Twitter post or a newsletter article about this. So I'm going to take my note with Twitter and newsletter. And the cool thing, if you use Zettelkasten or if you've seen my video on Zettelkasten, you know that you want to tag your notes not as categories of, you know, this is about CEO compensation or this is about publicly traded companies, but rather what you think you'll use this note for. And for me, I probably will turn this into a Twitter post, possibly expand on it and write a newsletter article about it. So if I tag them once I'm sitting there doing my Twitter, I don't have to think, oh, so what should I talk about today? I can just look it up in my Obsidian. What are the notes I've tagged as Twitter and go in there and pick one and start writing instead of, you know, sitting down, researching, not knowing what to do and waste time, right? Leverage everything that you've learned so far. So all you have to do is come to search here. You can search for the tag Twitter, for example, and it will show you the notes. Currently, I only have one. I might go back and start to tag some of the things I think I might write about, similar with newsletters. So I just want to show you this would be how you would tag in under the Zettelkasten method. And this is how you can leverage what you've read without, you know, redoing research every single time. Okay, and based on Obsidian's input, this is my output, but took probably 5 minutes to draw it up. That's a very painless experience. And I think once I have this, I'm going to put it back into my permanent notes, this illustration, and be able to, you know, use and build on it as we go, maybe into a newsletter article as well. So that was easy.
Day 6, getting more out of Obsidian with plugins.
Okay, I'm really excited for 2 plugins I found that really helped me visualize my ideas. As I've talked about before, you know, in the graph view, if you click here, you'll see that your ideas are starting to connect, right? There are usually nodes that start to emerge, and you'll see ideas are being connected between them. But if you go into your permanent notes, let's take an example, what makes someone successful, for example, it's really hard to know how you got there. I mean, you have links and you can trace them by going there and then see what else you've linked. There's something else here. So I want to see how my ideas connect. And that's where the first plugin, Journey, comes in. Okay, so once we've downloaded it, you'll see this pin icon on the sidebar that says Find Journey. If you click on it, you will see one, a starting note title you need and an ending note. And then you can find the journey and it'll show you all of the notes. What I like to do in the ending notes is always use a permanent note because these are the final ideas that came out of all the inputs we've had. So let's use what we did before, something about what makes someone successful. And then we want to see the journey from somewhere a bit random, right? So here, let me use one of my books, Bewilderment, I read, and let's see, what is the journey? Okay, so here we go, right? We went from Bewilderment, the book, to Double Blind, the book, from there to Pursuit of Happiness to Living versus Existing, and eventually to What Makes Someone Successful. So what is really cool about this is that in the graph view, we couldn't see how we would have never guessed, like Bewilderment, the book, which is a fiction book, which has nothing to do with success, so to speak, all the way links to an idea I have about, you know, what makes someone successful. So if I copy this to a clipboard and paste it, you'll see that it gives me all the links to the different notes that's mentioned. And in this way, let's say if I want to expand on an idea, let's say I give a presentation on how nature and neuroscience leads to success, I can use this as an outline, start to build out what it is I want to say. I can trace my own ideas and find interesting connections as well. So that is the first plugin that I'm really excited about. The second one is Excalidraw. If you follow me on Twitter and on YouTube, you know I like making visuals and mind maps. So I found this plugin that lets you draw right inside Obsidian. The cool part is you can add notes directly into the drawings, and when you click on them, it'll open the note for you. This way you can display your notes while you're drawing. So if you're a visual thinker, then it's so much easier to rearrange your thoughts. I'll be using Excalidraw for my YouTube scripts going forward. The mind map format is so much easier to organize my thoughts, and I can move points around, I can rearrange them, add new examples, take things out. So if you're a mind map user as well, you can supercharge your mind maps right in Obsidian. Day 7, what I wish I knew from day 1.
It's day 7. It's been a week since I started using Obsidian, and I want to talk about two things on the last day. The first one is definitely the things I wish I knew on day 1, so I would set up my vault completely differently. And the second thing is to show you graph view and see how much progress we've made in the last week. So let's start with the first thing I wish I knew, which are definitely more shortcuts, more functions, more hotkeys in Obsidian. So, you know, I can save myself time and stop doing manual work. I'll show you an example. I've been tracking beautiful sayings I've come across, and I used to copy and paste, but there is actually no need. All you need to do is use exclamation mark, double brackets, put in the note that you want to reference. Let's say I want to use this note about truth. Obsidian will immediately pull the content from that note for you. Especially if you're on your phone, it saves you so much time. I stopped doing these beautiful things because it was just too much work. It was really annoying copy and pasting. So now that I know you can do this, it's so much easier. If you guys are interested in these hotkeys, shortcuts, functions that I use, let me know in the comments below. I can make another video on this. Moving on to the second thing I wish I knew is definitely structure. When I started, I used folders and notes. I am a millennial, so you know I use folders, but I realize that Gen Z may not be thinking this way. And after using Obsidian, I understand why. Every time I'm looking for something, I am going into search, and I'm typing in things like, you know, decisions. And there, all of the content that has decision in it will come up. I never go into a folder to look up something. So going forward, I'm not going to use as many folders. The only time I do find folders are useful is one for in the Zettelkasten, if you're using it, in for permanent notes, because these are your ideas. These are the notes that came from you combining different ideas together. So if you're ever trying to find something that you have come up with, it's so much easier to go into a specific folder and browse through. Of course, you don't need a folder. You can actually just tag these as permanent notes, and it works the same way. So depending on how you like to categorize, that could be one way to do it. So yeah, I'm convinced. I'm not going to assign the destination of all my new notes. It's just extra work that doesn't need to happen. So that is one thing, structure. The other thing is, so the third thing that I wish I knew was to start using community plugins earlier. I would use plugins like Calendar, I would use things maybe like Kanban, so that I can organize my day as well. That would make me want to come back and use Obsidian more frequently, make it really a habit to track my ideas
in Obsidian. So I would definitely start with that as well. So if you're interested in more plugins, again, let me know in the comments. I'll show you how to set those things up. And now let's go to GraphView. So as you can see, there are nodes that are starting to appear. Still, it's only been a week, so we don't have that many nodes here. I will do another update maybe in a few months once I have a lot more nodes in here so that you can start to really see different ideas connecting and growing together. But compared to what we had before, this is really exciting. If you check out the animation, it's just amazing that all of these represent one idea that you've come across and you've captured so you can go back and look it up, right? If you want to see all the things that mention identity, for example, you can see them here. And it's only been a week. How many times has it appeared? So that's 7 days of Obsidian. Let me know in the comments below if you like this idea, if you're going to implement some of them. If you learn something new, definitely give it a thumbs up. Let me know. If there are topics you want me to cover, like the plugins or the shortcuts of functions I use frequently, let me know in the comments as well. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.